And the Toronto International Film Festival is in its final days now. And this year, the saying, art imitates life, can be seen in many of the films, especially when you consider the state of the world today. From individual struggles to international issues, all facets were covered, and RT's Alex Mihailovich is with us now in Toronto to break it all down. All right, Alex, before we get into the movies, you know, we're not quite Siskel and Ebert, but tell us about some of the highlights of TIFF 2017.
Yeah, no, we're not, but we're going to try to do our best, right? You know, festival takes over Toronto. I mean, in so many different ways. Not only are there tons of celebrities in the city, but many of the movie theaters participate in this, as well as the fact that the city's just more alive. Restaurants are packed. Our last call's 4 a.m., so you see people out at all hours, and there's tons of parties going on. But let's break it down. The festival itself, I mean, look, 500,000 people a year attend this festival. If you look at the numbers, just of the number of films, 340 films this year, 238 of those films premiered here, 147 of those were world premieres. And get this, over 7,000 films were submitted. So to whittle it down to the number that we have that were actually screened, that's massive. 74 countries participating. But let's not forget, TIFF is actually a year-round thing in Toronto. There's a place called the Bell Lightbox here that screens films like this all year through. It's just that during these 10 days, Toronto becomes the epicenter of film, I'd say, for the world, because there's just so much action here. It's unbelievable. And there's people from absolutely everywhere that are involved, not only in the process of TIFF, but in the filmmaking that goes behind it. The TIFF touched upon things, or some of these movies, it was the directors, it was the filmmakers that really, I think, wanted to be in touch with what's going on in the world today. And I'm going to start with a movie called Good Luck. Now, this movie is directed by Ben Russell. It's a French and German production. The first hour, you're in a copper mine in Serbia, the second, a gold mine in Suriname, and you're basically real time. You're going down into the mine with the miners, you're drilling for copper. It is boring as sin, but your mind is working the whole time, and it was extremely effective to get that message through, not only of what these people have submitted to, but just they basically given up on life. The second movie is Loveless. Now, this is about family conflict, a child, parents getting divorced. It's a Russian, French, German, and Belgian production. Andrei Zvyagintsev is the director, a very famous director, and an incredible director. The movie, as European movies are, something that we're not used to in North America, can be very dark, and it's not always a happy ending. Next, What Will People Say? I actually met the director, Irem Haak. She's from Norway. She's a Pakistani background. The production is Norwegian, German, and Sweden. Incredible movie about, we've heard the story before, a child getting taken from a country, taken back to the homeland. So the story is about a girl taken back to Pakistan to learn the old way of things being done, that not being too westernized. But there's a twist there. The father is the interesting character, not necessarily the main character, the girl. And finally, I'm just going to talk about Sheikh Jackson. This is an Egyptian production about an imam who falls in love, or who loved Michael Jackson all his life, and that is in this conflicted state when Michael Jackson dies. This is a city where half the people here weren't born in Canada. It's really fascinating, cosmopolitan mix of people from all over the world, different languages, different cultures, different histories, and that reflects the festival lineup, and that truly does. That's what makes Canada amazing, and that's what makes Toronto amazing for a festival like this. It truly is international, so you have audiences from the city that relate to all these different countries, and it's really this sort of multicultural mashup that makes for a fantastic festival, and I hope you can come next year so that we can be Siskel and Ebert together.
And the Toronto International Film Festival is in its final days now, and this year the saying, art imitates life, can be seen in many of the films, especially when you consider the state of the world today. From individual struggles to international issues, all facets were covered, and RT's Alex Mihailovich is with us now in Toronto to break it all down. All right, Alex, before we get into the movies, you know, we're not quite Siskel and Ebert, but tell us about some of the highlights of TIFF 2017.
Yeah, no, we're not, but we're going to try to do our best, right? Festival takes over Toronto. I mean, in so many different ways. Not only are there as boring as sin, but your mind is working the whole time, and it was extremely effective to get that message through, not only of what these people have submitted to, but just they basically given up on life. The second movie is Loveless. Now, this is about family conflict, a child, parents getting divorced. It's a Russian, French, German, and Belgian production. Andrei Zvyagintsev is the director, very famous director, and an incredible director. The movie, as European movies are, something that we're not used to in North America, can be very dark, and it's not always a happy ending. Next, what will people say? I actually met the director, Irem Haak. She's from Norway. She's a Pakistani background. The production is Norwegian, German, and Sweden. Tons of celebrities in the city, but many of the movie theaters participate in this, as well as the fact that the city's just more alive. Restaurants are packed. Our last call's 4 a.m., so you see people out at all hours, and there's tons of parties going on. But let's break it down. The festival itself, I mean, look, 500,000 people a year attend this festival. If you look at the numbers, just of the number of films, 340 films this year, 238 of those films premiered here, 147 of those were world premieres. And get this, over 7,000 films were submitted. So to whittle it down to the number that we have that were actually screened, that's massive. 74 countries participating. But let's not forget, TIFF is actually a year-round thing in Toronto. There's a place called the Bell Lightbox here that screens films like this all year through. It's just that during these 10 days, Toronto becomes the epicenter of film, I'd say, for the world, because there's just so much action here. It's unbelievable. And there's people from absolutely everywhere that are involved, not only in the process of TIFF, but in the filmmaking that goes behind it. The TIFF touched upon things, or some of these movies, I think really, it was the directors, it was the filmmakers that really, I think, wanted to be in touch with what's going on in the world today. And I'm going to start with a movie called Good Luck. Now, this movie is directed by Ben Russell. It's a French and German production. The first hour, you're in a copper mine in Serbia, the second, a gold mine in Suriname, and you're basically real time. You're going down into the mine with the miners, you're drilling for copper. An incredible movie about, you know, we've heard the story before, a child getting taken from a country, taken back to the homeland. So the story is about a girl taken back to Pakistan to learn the old way of things being done, that not being too westernized. But there's a twist there. The father is the interesting character, not necessarily the main character, the girl. And finally, I'm just going to talk about Sheikh Jackson. This is an Egyptian production about an imam who falls in love, or who loved Michael Jackson all his life, and that is in this conflicted state when Michael Jackson dies. This is a city where half the people here weren't born in Canada. It's really fascinating, cosmopolitan mix of people from all over the world, different languages.